Hi friends, welcome back all, and now we are going to see about Indiabulls Housing Finance Limited. So I think this momentum that has happened today, I think is really a very important momentum. I literally expected that Indiabulls Housing Finance to test that 200 rupees mark with by today itself, but I think yes, it is taking time, a bit of time, but friends, can it carry on the momentum? That is the main question. And remember one thing, 180 rupees was one of the buying price of a great investor, and I don't want to disclose the name, that we yourself know that we have already discussed it. But 207 is the QAP price which was set by Indiabulls Housing Finance Limited. I think those persons who have bought it 150 would be minting money right now. I mean the trader or the investor, whatever may the case be. But how should you position yourself from this trade? I think many people now will be constantly looking out for quarter third, because as the company said in the Q2 itself that they have been focusing on retail book, they are developing the retail book, and new management takeover is doing the good jobs. But whatever be the say, right, the Indiabulls Housing Finance not yet reached their book values, and that is what creating a bit of confusion in many people mind, because maybe the profit is good, maybe the management is good, but why didn't the share price has risen a great level, or why it not even tested book values? That is also a main point that has been hurting me. I believe that this share could trade in the range of around 300 rupees per 10, but I think it is taking a bit longer. I think the longer we wait, I think the better the result, because today we saw many shares, right? I mean, achieving the targets, going above the targets, and making a good comeback. I think similar case that applies to Indiabulls Housing Finance Limited. So friends, I think I already explained about the craziness in the market. Yes, the money is slowly shifting from sensor stocks and nifty stocks to mid-cap stocks. So this is not only an advice for Indiabulls Housing Finance Limited, but also to a trader who is trading in nifty and mid-cap stocks. So please be aware of each and every stock that you are trading in nifty and nifty and sensors, because the funds are slowly moving from nifty sensors to mid-cap and small-cap and other cap stocks, but a decent companies. Okay, so make sure when you trade is a cautious note. So now let us come to the ranges. So basically the range, I mean the breakout range I am setting is 207 rupees. Yes, for me the QIP price, that is 207, that would be a very 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 critical mark or a crucial mark. Yes, 200 rupees, the exact figure turnover is, that would be a difficult point to cross. But apart from that 207, the craziness that people will have in 200 would be lesser than when we compare to 207, because of the QAP price fixation. If it crosses that, I think that could be a good point, because the qualified institutional placement were made at 207, which means the investors made a current valuation of 207 rupees per share. So if the valuation improves from that level, then which make sure, okay, the company is bit of improving and the company is going what it meant to be. So with this good of hope, I think so friends, I think let us see how the markets are going to place it, because literally expected today that India should cross 200. After reaching 188, I thought okay, maybe it could be the day today, but it didn't. So let us wait for another week or so, or let us, I mean, who knows, maybe tomorrow so this share can cross 200 rupees. If tomorrow sir got so this, then very much good. But let us see. It could take time, and I hope it will take time, but the result would be positive. So let us see what's gonna happen, friends. And this is about Indiabulls Housing Finance Limited. Thank you, friends, and listen to the video very soon.